Hello everyone, my name is Svetlana. I live in Western Australia. I'm originally Russian and English is my second language. So if I make any mistakes or you find my accent awkward, I'm apologizing. But yeah, I'm probably my English better than your Russian. And today I want to talk about scandals in fragrance world, in perfumery. I have few stories where fragrances were involved in quite a scandal stories. And story number one is about poison and perfume. And it's not about Dior poisons. This story is about poisoning of Russian citizen Sergei Skripal and his daughter Julia in United Kingdom in Salisbury place. And don't expect that I will express any political opinion. There will be no political opinion, just facts. And this is a video about perfume. So on the 4th of March 2018, Mr. Sergei Skripal and his daughter Yulia were found on the public bench in the city of Salisbury in United Kingdom unconscious. They were brought to the hospital and it was found that they were poisoned. Also, the policeman who visited their house to check, to do the check, he also was poisoned and spent time in the hospital, also got unconscious. At the end of March, Yulia Skripal got conscious and consequently her father got conscious in May 2018. It was found that they were poisoned by the chemical agent, which later was called, or earlier was called Novichok, but it got in the media under this name, and it was considered as a Russian mass killing chemical agent, which is banned by the Organization for Banning and Control of the Chemical Weapon. Later on, two Russian citizens, Mr. Boshirov and Mr. Petrov, were found guilty, were suspected. I don't know if they were found guilty, I don't know the legal side of the case. They were suspected in the poisoning, and later on, the British intelligence service, MI5, claimed that those two guys are the agents of the special intelligence force of Russia. I said will be not political, only facts. And when their hotel room were checked, they were found the traces of this poisoning chemical agent, and their hotel room was checked in August, I assume. So for about 6 months, someone lived in that room, and who knows, maybe those people were poisoned as well, maybe not to that extent. And the worst thing happened later. But before I start about the story about perfume, I should say about who was Mr. Skripal. Mr. Sergei Skripal was a employee of the Russian intelligence service. He worked in the human resource department of the service, and he was leaking the personal data of the personnel of the service to the British intelligence service. And he was found guilty in this, and he was sentenced for 13 years in the Russian prison, but later on was exchanged for the group of spies between Russia and I think USA, maybe UK. I don't know the story very well. So he got in UK and somehow he got a house, he got a car, and he got a job in MI5 and was teaching British agents on how to find and disclose the Russian special force agents. And allegedly that was, I think that fact was behind thinking that it was revenge from Russian intelligence service to do poisoning. And as far as I know from media, Mr. Skripal and his daughter Yulia moved to New Zealand. I don't know, it's in, from media, it's not from me. they changed their names, maybe they changed how they look like, changed the documents, and probably live somewhere in happily in New Zealand. But why I'm talking about this? Because also in July, or May, July, don't remember. So a few months later, in about 10 kilometers from Salisbury, where the Skripals were found unconscious, the British poor woman or homeless woman found a bottle of perfume in the garbage bin, and it was found in the box like this, exactly the same, and the name was Premier Jour, Nina Ricci, the first day. And what was inside, it was a like a cylinder bottle, plastic one or glass one, not sure, with a sticker, Premier Jour, Nina Ricci, and a low nozzle, not a normal spray like we use, those people who like perfumes, and not in the original bottle. And the intelligence or police said even this box was from fake perfume, but it looked exactly the same as this one, so maybe high quality fake. But the real one looks like this. So it says Premier Jour, and this is Nina Ricci. Has a nice spray, has a beautiful cap. It's plastic, but it's like thick, you know, it's whole, the solid plastic. The perfume was developed in 2001, and the noses behind these are Sophie Labbe and Carlos Benaim. And Carlos Benaim, both perfumers are very famous, and they created many other famous perfumes. This perfume is with the main note is a sweet pea. Not pea, pea. the flower. I recently moved from another area in Perth, and when I went to work every day, I was passing by a cafe which had a nice little garden with a sweet peas. And this is very photorealistic, but also this one has a mandarin, it has musk, it has amber, orchid, vanilla, and the musk. Yeah, very beautiful. Very high quality, perfect for day, perfect for summer, perfect for winter, maybe a little bit too flowery for autumn and no, too flowery for autumn and winter, but perfect for spring and summer. Great for office. If you like a very feminine, it cannot be unisex. I cannot imagine men using it. Very feminine, very beautiful. If it was a Kardashian perfume and something like this happened with Kardashian perfume, then this perfume would be selling in millions, billions, and making a lot of money. I don't know why Nina Ricci brand didn't use it. It's a really high quality perfume, and it's a poison perfume now. It's a new poison, poison of the 21st century. Not Dior poison, this is a poison. Very innocent, actually, cannot be poison. And another version of this perfume I found just by chance. I was buying something else from a collector and they said, "Do you like this?" I said, "I don't know if I like it or not. Just give it to me." And this still has the DNA, but it's much less sweeter. I feel iris here. It's not in Fragrantica, so I have to rely on my own nose and mind, my brain and nose, and connections between them. So I think it's iris. It has a mask, and it's much stricter and more formal perfume. I would say for office, more formal for office, not like formal event, wedding or theater. Beautiful bottle with like a petrol like, you see, yeah. And I think this one can be used, I don't know why it's office perfume. Yeah, quite cold, distant. It's in the same vibe as Chanel number 19 Poudre, but even less sweet. It's still fresh. So if you have a chance to find it somewhere, it called summer edition, or the toilet pour letter. Nice. And the last question I had about all this story with poisoning is, why two men? If the version of Mi 5 is true, then why two men were carrying purely female perfume with poison? They didn't have any other bottles? Why it must be perfume? Okay, let's assume it must be perfume. You can put it in deodorant, you can put it in the shaving cream. Why you put it in the female perfume box? And female name on the perfume bottle. It's very feminine. It's not unisex at all. So I still have this question in my mind. I cannot answer it. Anyway, it doesn't make this perfume any worse. It's fantastic. It's still possible to buy. I think it will be discontinued soon, if not discontinued yet. And if you have a chance to buy, it's not expensive, and it's a legend now, after being in scandal. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Bye.